For many of our Asian neighbors, a rice dish represents a full meal in itself. One genius version is a Korean dish called bibimbap, traditionally served as a bowl of warm white rice loaded with seasoned vegetables, chili pepper paste, egg, and sliced meat. Full course meal, enough to satisfy any grumbling tummy. But today, I thought of putting a Filipino spin to it. Since many of us just couldn't imagine having our binagoongang baboy without a serving of warm rice, why not just put them all together in one dish inspired by the Korean bibimbap? Bibimbap literally means mixed meal or mixed rice. And that's exactly what I'm gonna do right now. I'm gonna mix together two cultures that we love so much. I'm making bagoong rice bibimbap. It's a merry mix of bagoong, white rice, pork, carrots, green mango, bean sprouts, kangkong, and egg. I know, it sounds freakishly awesome. So let's not wait. Let's start. First, I'll heat up the pans, and then I'm gonna slice the toppings. So I'll start with some green mango. It's the perfect complement to bagoong. I'm gonna slice that thinly. I'm gonna set this aside. And then some carrots. I'm gonna slice them julienne as well. But of course they come round, so the first thing you do is slice off the edges, just so that they're gonna be easy to control. And then again, slice them really thinly. And I want all my toppings to be thin or julienne because I want the rice to be the star of the dish. I don't want to overwhelm it with all the flavors of the toppings. I'm gonna set that aside as well. And then we're gonna start sauteing. So I've got a pan here. All I need is a little bit of vegetable oil. I'm gonna season that with some salt and pepper. Just toss this around. Why not get a workout while cooking? So since I cut this julienne, this is probably gonna cook in about a minute or two. We wanna still keep it nice and crisp. Okay, I'm gonna get a plate. Just gonna set it aside. Then some bean sprouts, just dump that all in. And again, season it with salt and pepper. Again, toss. You know, one of the keys to a successful flip is actually the facial expression. So just watch this. I'm gonna set this aside. Just a little bit more oil. And then we're gonna cook our kangkong leaves. Again, season with some salt and pepper. We're just gonna wilt them down. We still wanna keep them crunchy. And these are good to go. So I've got a traditional Korean stone bowl here. And this is where we're gonna cook our bibimbap. First, some pork belly. I'm gonna season that with some salt and pepper also. We're just gonna let it sear and color on one side. So these Korean bowls are actually easy to find. Just go to any Korean restaurant that has a market at the back, and they usually sell this. So let's mix this up. And then I'm gonna add some garlic, make it really fragrant. And then some bagoong. Now you can use any flavor of bagoong you'd like. I'm using the sweet kind now because I think it's gonna offset that sour green mango. Whew, the smell, really good. All right, that's all mixed up. Then we're gonna dump in our white rice. Can add in about 2 cups of rice. All right, let's mix this up. This is basically done. Now we're gonna add the toppings, but I'm gonna keep the heat on so that we can get that nice crunchy bits at the bottom. With bibimbap, time is of the essence, so I've got to taste it now. Oh my God. It is everything you want in binagoong ang baboy. There's the saltiness, the sourness. It's very rich. Man, I promise you, this is not just a dish. It's an experience.